Hello students, today we are going to multiply a complex number with another complex number. Already we have seen the two parts of the multiplication. Now we are going to discuss about how to multiply a complex number with another complex number. Let we see. Let us take, let z1 is equal to 3 plus I and z2 equal to 1 plus I. How to multiply these two complex numbers? Z1 into z2 equal to 3 plus I into 1 plus I. So how to multiply these two? So there are various methods. One is directly you can multiply. So I am going to deal by method 1. By method 1, just to multiply these two complex numbers. As usual multiplication, 1 into 3 is 3. 1 into 3 is 3 plus 1 into I. 1 into I is I. Plus I into 3. I into 3, 3i plus I into I square. So now I am simplifying 3 plus I plus 3i plus I square is minus 1. So the result is 3 minus 1 is 2, 3i plus I is 4i. So again, when you multiply two complex numbers, again you are getting a complex number. Is it clear? Z1 into Z2 gives 2 plus 4i. 2 is the real part of Z and 4 is the imaginary part of Z. This is the standard form. That is 2 plus 4i is the rectangular form or standard form of representing a complex number. Is it clear? Then, now I am going to represent in method 2. Method 2. How will you represent? Let us take 3 here. Write the real part here. Imaginary part is I here. Similarly, second one, real part is 1. Imaginary part is I. So, I am going to multiply real part. So, I want to get the real part. How will you get real part? I am multiplying the real 3 into 1, 3. Then, I am multiplying the imaginary. That is, multiplying the real, multiplying the imaginary. You will get the real part. Real part of Z1, Z2. Product Z1, Z2. So, I into I square, that is minus 1. So, 3 minus 1 gives the answer as 2. See here, here also 2, here also 2. Now, to get the imaginary part of Z1, Z2. How to get imaginary part of Z1, Z2? Again, I am writing real, imaginary, 3i, 1i. Just cross multiply it. 3 into I, 3i, 1 into I plus 1i. So the answer is 4i. So imaginary part of Z1, Z2 is 4i. Is it clear now? So the complex number Z1, Z2 is, see here, the complex number Z1, Z2, now Z1, Z2 2 becomes 2 plus 4i. So these are the two methods you can easily find out. Or, and the another method is multiply the real part, multiply the imaginary part, then subtract. That is little bit difficult for you. So, this is enough. So, you can use method 1 or method 2 to multiply, to find the multiplication of the two complex numbers. Okay. Next one, how to divide or division of two complex numbers. Division of two complex numbers. Complex numbers. Before that, first I want to tell how to find out. Division means what? Let us take Z1 is equal to A plus IB. If Z1 is equal to A plus IB, Z2 equal to C plus ID. I want to divide Z1 by Z2. So what we are going to do here is A plus IB by C plus ID. Here I am going to introduce a new concept, but I will explain in the next video. Anyway, C plus ID, I am taking the conjugate. I will explain the conjugate part in next video. But just to note this one, this is enough now. So C plus ID means the conjugate of C plus ID is C minus ID by C minus ID. What I am doing? Multiply and divide by the conjugate of C plus ID. That is C minus ID by C minus ID. Now you can understand that what is the conjugate. Conjugate means we are going to change the sign of the imaginary part alone. Already you did this method in certs also. If 2 plus root 3 is a third, then the conjugate of 2 plus root 3 is 2 minus root 3. What you are doing? You are changing the sign of the third. In this manner, we are doing this. C plus ID conjugate is C minus ID. So, I am going to multiply and divide by C minus ID. Now, see the numerator as usual multiplication. You can apply any method. Now, I am going to use this method. Real, imaginary, A, IB, C minus ID. I want to get the real part. How to get the real part? AC. Direct multiplication. Direct arrow. AC. Real part AC. Direct arrow. BD. I into I square. I square is minus 1. Already here minus is here. So it becomes plus BD. Is it clear now? Imaginary part. Now I am going to find out the imaginary part. What is imaginary part? Just cross multiply these two. If I am cross multiplying, this means I am getting the negative sign. So, I am multiplying these two. So, this is I into BC. So, I am taking out I outside BC. Here also I am taking out I outside. So, the answer is minus AD. So, what is A plus IB into C minus ID? AC plus BD plus I into BC minus AD. Whole thing divided by. Again I have to multiply the denominator. See, I am writing the denominator as C. This is of the form A plus B into A minus B. Just check. This is of the form A plus B into A minus B. What is A plus B into A minus B? You know the formula as A plus B into A minus B as. What is A plus B into A minus B? A square minus B square. I am applying the same concept. C square minus ID the whole square, which is equal to AC plus BD plus I into BC minus AD. BC minus AD whole thing divided by C square. This becomes plus. Why? I square becomes minus 1 minus into minus plus D square. Is it clear now? So I want to represent it in the standard form or rectangular form. What is the meaning of rectangular form? You have to get the real part and the imaginary part separately. So, AC plus BD by C square plus D square plus I into BC minus AD by C square plus D square. Here the real part is AC plus BD by C square plus D square, BC minus AD by C square plus D square. The imaginary part is BC minus AD by C square plus D square. So, this form is called as rectangular form or standard form of a complex number. So, Z1 by Z2 is nothing but this is the answer. So, once again repeating you, I have introduced a new concept here. C plus ID, we are multiplying numerator and denominator by C minus ID. So, C minus ID is nothing but conjugate of C plus ID. But I will delete this chapter or I will take this chapter in next class. Okay, is it clear now? Let me do some more problems in this. Let me see an example. Let Z1 is equal to minus 1 plus I. Z2 equal to 2 plus I. Now we are interested in finding out Z1 by Z2. How to find out Z1 by Z2? Minus 1 plus I by 2 plus I. What is the conjugate of 2 plus I? 2 minus I by 2 minus I. How to multiply the numerator? You can apply any method. So, I am writing this as real, imaginary, minus 1, 1, sorry, I, 2, minus I. I want to get the real part. What is the real part? Direct multiplication. 2 into minus 1, minus 2, I into I square. I square is minus 1. Already minus is here, plus 1. So, minus 2 plus 1 gives the answer as minus 1. Is it clear? Now, I am going to find out the imaginary part. What is the imaginary part? Imaginary part is you have to cross multiply the two numbers. So, cross imaginary means cross multiplication. Real means direct multiplication. Is it clear? So, cross multiplication. Minus 1 into minus I, it becomes I. 2 into I becomes 2I. So, the answer is 2I plus I, 3I. Divided by 2 plus I into 2 minus I looks like A plus B into A minus B. So, A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square, that is I square, which is equal to minus 1 plus 3I by 4 minus I square is minus 1, here is minus 1 plus 1, which is equal to minus 1 by 5 plus 3 by 5 I. This is the rectangular form or standard form of Z1 by Z2. Is it clear now? Okay. One more example I want to show you. One more example. How to find out I power minus 1? Find I power minus 1. How to find out I power minus 1? I power minus 1 is nothing but 1 by I. How to find a 1 by I? So 1 by I, yeah, I am going to take the conjugate. What is the meaning of conjugate? We have to change the sign of the imaginary part. Here the imaginary part is only I. So sign of the imaginary part minus I by minus I. Is it clear? So the answer is minus I by I into I square. I square is minus 1. Already you are having minus. So the answer is plus 1, which is equal to minus I. So keep it in your mind. The value of 1 by I is nothing but minus I. Once again repeating, the value of 1 by I is minus I. Is it clear now? So we have come across all the operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. But I have to explain one concept, that is conjugate of a complex number. Okay. Now we are going to see about the some of the properties of complex numbers. Properties of complex numbers. That is, properties means algebraic properties. Algebraic properties on complex numbers. Algebraic properties. What is the meaning of algebraic property? Already you know, you have learnt in lower classes that first property is closure property. Algebraic property applicable for two ways. One is for addition and another one is for multiplication. First we are going to discuss about algebraic property on addition, then we will discuss about algebraic property on multiplication. Let us take closure property. What is the meaning of closure property? If we take any two complex numbers, take Z1 and Z2, you can check the answer. Just I am giving you the property, you can check all these properties. With respect to addition, Z1 plus Z2 is also belongs to the complex numbers. Z1, Z2 belongs to any complex number. Take any two complex numbers. Whatever may be the complex number, you can take. If you take any two complex number, their addition is also a complex number. Similarly, next one, commutative property or commutative property. You can check with any two complex number. Please check whether you are getting the result or not. Suppose if you are not getting the result, means message me. Commutative property, take Z1, Z2 belongs to any two complex number. Then if Z1, Z2 belongs to any two complex number, any two same or different anything, Z1 plus Z2 is equal to Z2 plus Z1. Again it becomes the complex number. So this property is called as commutative property over the operation addition. Then coming to the next one, associative property. What is associative property? In associative property, we need two complex numbers. If three complex numbers, Z1, Z2 and Z3 belongs to a complex numbers, or three different complex numbers, or same complex number, anything. This says Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3. Like our number system only. In natural number, what will you do? If you want to take three elements, you can add any two elements, then add the third one. Similarly, Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 equal to, you can easily say the answer is Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3. Is it clear? We can change the bracket, the value will not change. Then the fourth property, identity property. Identity property, please listen this properties and do all the sums, because the same one is applicable in the last exercise in second volume of your state board book. That is, in discrete mathematics you will get the same, you have to apply the same result in the discrete mathematics also. Identity property. What is the meaning of identity property? Let Z1 or Z be any complex number. You know the meaning of identity. Identity means it is an element which satisfies the given condition. That is, let Z belongs to C, then there exist, one number 0 belongs to C, such that, you can say that Z plus 0 equal to 0 plus Z. What is the result? Which is always Z. So this 0 is called as the additive identity of complex number. Additive identity. Is it clear now? So what is the additive identity of the complex number? Means the additive identity of, it is not the complex number. Additive identity, is meant for group, full set. Group, you cannot say that group. Identity is meant for the full set. So 0. 0 is nothing but 0 plus 0i. Is it clear, all of you? So what is the additive identity? 0 plus 0i. The identity occurs for the group. But next we are going to discuss about inverse property. Inverse property. What is the meaning of inverse property? For Z belongs to a complex number, then there exists, instead of writing then there exists, you can write the symbol like this also. Then there exists Z inverse, which is equal to 1 by Z. Sorry, Z inverse is equal to minus Z belongs to C. You know what is the meaning of minus Z? Negative of Z. How will you get negative of Z? Negative of Z is nothing but we have to change the sign of the real part as well as change the sign of the imaginary part. Minus Z belongs to C, such that, Z plus minus Z equal to minus Z plus Z equal to 0, which gives identity. So see, there is the little bit difference between, these two set. Identity means identity is applicable for the full set, complex number itself. So in complex number there is only one identity. Be careful. In a complex number set there will be only one identity. See here, this is a complex number set, means there will be only one identity 0. But inverse means there are lot of elements in the complex numbers. Z1, Z2, Z3, etc. For every element you will get one inverse. For additive inverse means for Z1 you will get the additive inverse as minus Z1. Z2 you will get the additive inverse as minus Z2. Once again I want to repeat the inverse property of, properties of complex numbers with respect to addition. Just to see here, for Z belongs to C, then there exists, I am writing then there exists in this notation, okay. I am writing Z bar, this is wrong. Note this point. Z bar is wrong. This is applicable only for multiplicative inverse. So once again I am repeating, for Z belongs to C, then there exists minus Z, that is negative of Z. Negative of Z belongs to C, such that Z plus minus Z equal to minus Z plus Z equal to 0. Is it clear, all of you? So in inverse property, for an element Z belongs to C, the additive inverse of Z is only minus Z, not Z bar. Z bar is applicable for what? Multiplication only. So I will deal this multiplication in within few seconds, or I will explain this Z power minus 1 in next session. Let we see algebraic properties on multiplication. Algebraic properties on multiplication. Check all these sums. Anyway, I will give you sums to verify all these properties in an exercise so that you can easily understand. Algebraic properties of multiplication. The closure property. First one is closure property. So what is the closure property? Say as same as addition. Take any two complex numbers z1 comma z2 belongs to C, then z1 into z2 also belongs to C. If z1 z2 belongs to C, then z1 into z2 also belongs to C. When we add two complex number, again we will get a complex number. When you multiply two complex number, again you will get a complex number. Next one, let me check. Commutative property. Like addition, z1 comma z2 belongs to C, then z1 into z2 equal to z2 into z1. This is the commutative property, lies as same as addition. Then coming to identity property. Identity property. For z belongs to C, then there exists as same as the number system. What is the meaning of identity in the number system for multiplication? When you take any number, take a number A and multiply the number with the any number, again you have to get A. What is the number? It is nothing but 1. Similarly, for z belongs to Z, then there exist 1 belongs to C, such that z into 1 equal to 1 into z equal to z. So how will you write 1? 1, or I can write this as 1 plus 0i also. 1 is purely real, be careful. So z into 1 is equal to 1 into z is equal to z. Therefore, which property exists? Identity property exists. Now coming to associative property. First I have to mention associative property. Anyway, after that I am mentioning it. Associative property. Associative property is, take any three elements z1, z2, z3. Is it clear? In a complex number. Z1, z3, z1, z2, z3 in a complex number. As same as addition, z1 into z2 into z3 equal to z1 into z2 into z3. Is it clear now? So associative property also holds good in which one? Algebraic properties of multiplication. Okay. The last one is inverse property. Inverse property. Okay. Inverse property for like as same as the number system. Inverse property in multiplication, what will you say? Take an element A. When it is multiplied by one number, you will get the what? Identity. Multiplicative identity is 1. So A is multiplied with what gives 1? It should be 1 by A. In the same manner, for z1 belongs to C, instead of writing then there exists fully, I am writing like this. Then there exists 1 by z1. Be careful. 1 by z1 belongs to C. And already I want to mention this one. In division of complex number, I forgot. So once again, I am reminding you under the condition that z1 is not equal to 0. In division of complex numbers, I explained to you like z1 by z2. We have find the division, but this is possible only if z2 is not equal to 0. Division is possible only if z2 is not equal to 0. Similarly, here z1 is not equal to 0. So z1 belongs to complex number, then there exists 1 by z1 belongs to C, z1 not equal to 0, such that z1 into 1 by z1 equal to 1 by z1 into z1 equal to, what will you get? 1. 1 is nothing but, already I told you, 1 is nothing but 1 plus 0i. So which property also exists? Inverse property. So we are, all the properties are existing for addition as well as multiplication of complex number. Closure, commutative, identity, associative and inverse. Okay. Now let me see one more property. Distributive property. The common property. Distributive property. Already you heard about this property in your lower classes. The same we are applying for complex number also. What is the meaning of distributive? Distributive means we are going to distribute one operation with the another operation. See here, don't confuse with associative property. In associative property, all are multiplication. See here, Z1 into Z2 into Z3. Similarly, in properties of complex number, addition also, associative means Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3. See, the symbol is plus, here also plus. But distributive property means, we are taking three complex numbers, Z1, Z2 and Z3 belongs to complex number. Z1 multiplied with Z2 plus Z3. See here, if you are having both the signs as multiplication, it becomes associative. Here you are having multiplication, here you are addition. So this property is called as distributive property. Z1 into Z2 plus Z3, what will you get? Z1 into Z2 plus Z1 into Z3. This is called as distributive of multiplication over addition. Similarly, you can write it as Z1 into Z2 minus Z3. What is the answer? Z1 into Z2 minus Z1 into Z3. Is it clear? Now we have seen all the algebraic properties of multiplication in complex number. But I want to repeat once again the inverse property. For Z1 belongs to C, then there exists 1 by Z1 belongs to C. So this 1 by Z1, already I told you, no? For additive property, inverse is minus Z. But for the multiplication function, inverse property is 1 by Z1, that 1 by Z1 is nothing but Z1 power minus 1. Here only you have to use Z1 power minus 1. So, for Z1 belongs to C, then there exists Z1 power minus 1 which is equal to 1 by Z1 belongs to C. And note that Z1 not equal to 0, such that Z1 into Z1 power minus 1 or 1 by Z1 equal to 1 by Z1 into Z1 equal to. Is it clear, all of you? So, once again repeating, additive inverse of Z is minus Z and multiplicative inverse of Z is 1 by Z. Once again repeating, additive inverse of Z is minus of the Z, multiplicative inverse is reciprocal of the Z. Note this point. Let me see one example using this complex number. Let us take an example. Now let us take the example, find x and y. If 3 plus I into x plus 4 minus I into y equal to x plus 6 plus iy plus 2y. So how to find out the value of x and y? These two complex numbers are equal. But this is not in standard form. So I am converting this into standard form. How to convert standard form? I am taking all the real parts and imaginary parts separately. Here the real part is 3x. Here the real part is 4y. So 3x plus 4y plus, take the imaginary part, here ix, so I am taking out I outside, ix, that 4x minus iy, so I am taking out I outside, x minus y. I am simplifying this also, x plus 6, so x plus 6 plus 2y, taking the real part. Plus iy. Is it clear? So if these two complex numbers are equal, means using the equality property, equating the real part and equating the imaginary part. Equating real and imaginary parts. So 3x plus 4y equal to x plus 2y plus 6. And imaginary part x minus y equal to y. Is it clear? So on simplification, 3x minus x is 2x, 4y minus 2y is 2y equal to 6. Here you will get x minus, I am taking y this side, 2y equal to 0. So consider this as first equation, consider this as second equation. I am going to solve these two equations, that's all. You can apply any method solving these two equations. But I am noticing that here is 2y, here is minus 2y. So just I am subtracting. I am adding 1 and 2. That is 2x plus 2y equal to 6. X minus 2y equal to 0. Just adding. 2x plus x, 3x equal to 6. Therefore, x is equal to 2. Substitute in second equation, because this is easy for me, so I am substituting. X is equal to 2, 2 minus 2y equal to 0. Substituting x is equal to 2, 2 minus 2y equal to 0. I am taking 2y that side. 2y equal to 2. Therefore, y is equal to. Is it clear now? To get the conceptual clarity, I have chosen the sums which are not in the book. Please do all the sums. Thank you.